Welcome to the Dam Owner Academy, brought to you by the Association of State Dam Safety Officials, or ASDSO, a series of videos to educate and inform on all aspects of operating and maintaining a dam safely. This video will cover historical dam failures. Hundreds of dams have failed throughout the history of the United States, causing property damage, environmental impacts, and thousands of fatalities. A dam failure is generally defined as any uncontrolled loss of the reservoir. Dams hold tremendous volumes of water that can be unleashed in the event of a failure, and owners are responsible and liable for the safety of their structures. Owners of dams and their operating and maintenance personnel must be knowledgeable of the potential problems that can lead to failure. Studying historical dam safety incidents and the lessons learned can provide valuable insight to those who own, operate, and regulate dams to help avoid similar catastrophes in the future. The causes of most dam failures fit into one of four primary categories, and we'll discuss each one briefly. The first common cause of failure is overtopping. In extreme floods, inflows to a reservoir might exceed the capacity of a dam's spillways, causing water levels to rise over the crest of the structure. Most dams aren't designed to be overtopped by the reservoir. The erosive action of uncontrolled flowing water can quickly damage and fail an earthen embankment or undercut the foundation of a concrete dam. All dams should be equipped with spillways sized to safely pass normal and flood flows downstream. A professional engineer can help determine whether your spillway has adequate capacity based on your state's dam safety program requirements. If a dam spillway capacity is insufficient, the dam should be upgraded by increasing the capacity of a spillway, raising the dam to increase its storage capacity, or armoring the dam so it can survive overtopping flows. The next common cause of failure for dams is inadequate maintenance and upkeep. Like all infrastructure, dams are built with an expected design life and require maintenance to operate as intended. Many older dams weren't constructed to modern standards and engineering practice. As a dam approaches the end of its design life, it may require rehabilitation or replacement. Even minor issues such as erosion, animal burrows, overgrown vegetation, and cracks on concrete structures can progress into more severe problems over time. If maintenance isn't performed promptly, these minor issues may eventually lead to failure. All dams should have a comprehensive operation and maintenance plan that includes regular inspections, performance monitoring, and maintenance. Another common cause of failure is seepage and piping. All earthen materials are permeable to water to some extent. Concrete dams are susceptible to seepage through the foundation, and on earthen dams, water can seep through the embankment itself. Seepage on its own is usually not a problem if the volume of water is small and the dam is appropriately designed. Many dams have drains that both filter and collect seepage, so it can't cause internal erosion or build up pressure. However, if seepage is not controlled, it can lead to internal erosion of a dam or its foundation. The erosion can even create an open pathway upstream toward the reservoir called piping. If piping is allowed to progress unchecked, it can quickly lead to failure. Seepage can also weaken the soils within an embankment or foundation through increased pressure, leading to a slope failure or a structural collapse. All seepage through a dam should be filtered by an engineered drainage system and monitored over time for any changes that might indicate a problem. The fourth common cause of dam failures is structural issues. Concrete dams can experience instability or movement over time from reservoir water pressure or uplift pressure in the foundation. Appurtenant structures like spillways, outlet works, and gates are also subject to structural problems that can lead to an uncontrolled loss of the reservoir. Non-earthen structures deteriorate through cracking, corrosion, and differential settlement, and these issues can progress into more severe problems if not addressed. Your dam should have an in-depth technical inspection by a professional engineer at least every 5 years, or as required by your state, and following any event that could affect the structure, such as a major storm, earthquake, or landslide. Make sure that planned changes to your dam or its appurtenant structures have been evaluated by a professional engineer and approved by your state before you start construction. Although many failures fall into these four typical causes, all dam safety incidents are unique, and many have occurred even on dams with robust oversight and regular upkeep. owners, regulators, engineers, and the public can benefit from studying the causes and effects of historical safety events. The Association of State Dam Safety Officials maintains free resources about dam safety incidents at damfailures.org. One resource on this website, the Case Study Database, contains detailed summaries of more than 50 historical dam safety incidents. These case studies have been prepared to provide a better understanding of the underlying causes of dam failures and how they might be prevented in the future. Each peer-reviewed case history includes a narrative description of the event, photographs and videos of the incident, if available, links to references and further resources, and the lessons learned by those involved. The case studies are searchable by keyword, dam type, and failure mode. Damfailures.org also includes a database of lessons learned from dam safety incidents and failures. Each peer-reviewed lesson has been prepared with a detailed description and background, photos, videos, best practices, and other resources. In addition, the lessons learned are cross-referenced to the case study database so you can explore the related safety incidents. Finally, ASTSO maintains a dam safety incident database that provides essential information on recent and historical incidents as a reference for stakeholders, the media, and the public. As always, consult with a qualified professional engineer for any concerns related to the safety or integrity of your dam. In addition to the failure information described, the Association of State Dam Safety Officials has free resources available to help owners operate and maintain their dams safely. Contact your state dam safety program for additional help, and be sure to check out ASDSO's website at damowner.org for more information.